Good morning, everyone. This is a small video lecture provided for you related to shortest path routing algorithm. We also know that by other name called Dijkstra's algorithm. As I heard that some of you have a problem related how to solve this problem, so I just worked out on this and I've presented this in a format of a video. In the same way, I'll provide you the PDF related to this particular topic. You can go through that also. So same to whatever you're seeing here, the same thing will be represented in a format of PDF, and that will be represented to you. So right now we'll discuss about something called shortest path routing algorithm. So you can see there is a problem, there is a graph given here. This is the graph. So initial node, the source node, what we usually call, is represented as node A. From here we need to find the shortest path. So here, coming to this particular algorithm, shortest path routing algorithm, what we exactly do is, we from the initial node, that is the source node, we'll try to find out the shortest path to each and every node that exists here. Like for example, what is the shortest path from node A to node B? What is the shortest path from node A to node C? Same way, what is the shortest path from node A to G, A to E, A to F, H and D? Okay, so this is what we exactly do in this particular routing algorithm. But before that, I just want to clarify it that whatever the values you people are seeing here, the 2, 7, 2, 2, 3, so these are nothing but the distance. It can be of any unit. Maybe it is a distance, it may be a cost to reach from node A to node B. For example, if you observe here, you can consider this either as a cost, the cost incurred to move from node A to node B. It is true. Or it can be like a or it can be measured as a distance. The distance to move from node A to node B is 2, or some units, 2 kilometers or 2 meters or 200 meters, whatever it might be, that observes. So that is what I have represented in this particular right side of the column, that in exam they may give you different ways. Like it may be in a format of a weight, that is nothing but distance. Right now I'm considering this as a distance, okay, or you can consider it as cost also. Same way, it can be represented as a parameter called as time. Time in the sense, the time taken to move from node A to node B is around 2 minutes or 2 seconds or 2 hours, whatever it might be. So it can be represented in that way also. That depends upon the question. They'll provide you the information in that. Same way, hops. Now when we talk about the third point, that is hops here, so these values will not be provided if they are talking about hops, because a hop is nothing but the intermediate node between the source node and the destination. For example, I want to find the shortest path from node A to node E. Okay, assume that these values are not present here. Whatever the values you people are saying, assume these are not given. Now how we can determine that what is the shortest path from A to E? Since we know there are two different paths from A to reach E, either via node B or via node G. Now if these values are not provided, you can observe that there is only one intermediate stop to go from node A to node E. So definitely both have become the shortest path. In case there are some one more node here from A to G, G to some other value, and from here to E, then what happens? From A to E we'll be having two nodes, G, and here also we'll have one more node, so two nodes. But whereas coming from via B, we have only one single node, so definitely the shortest path will be A, B, E to reach. Okay, so that is what called hops. Hops is nothing but the intermediate node between the the number of intermediate nodes between source node A to E. Okay, that can be depends upon the source node and the destination. Now let's start the problem. We'll solve the problem here. The initial thing what do you people have to do when this problem is given is, you first have to take a pair to each and every node. So when you're taking this pair, AB, every node, you people have to represent this pair, which consists of two parameters, okay? The first parameter is the distance, and the second parameter is from which particular node you're getting that distance. That you people are representing here, okay? So this is what has been done in this particular steps. If you observe here, so this is the source. So every source node will be represented with arrow like this, okay? So initially A is our source node and the distance is 0, because from source node to source node will not have any value. Same way, we are not coming via any other node, so dash. Now remaining all will be infinite minus infinite dash infinite minus infinite. What does this pair mean? That we haven't reached there right now. So this, in the next step what we can do is, okay, so in the very next step what we can do is nothing but from source node A we'll find the shortest path to B and G. Okay, so since we don't have any intermediate nodes, for A to B definitely this is the only path we do have, so we'll update that with 2, A. So 2 is nothing but the distance from A. Okay, and same way for G to go, what is the distance? Is 6. So we are represented 6 comma A. Now in this, after updating this B and G nodes, what are the nearby nodes that are present for A? We need to find the next source, which one we need to consider. So obviously the topic itself is regarding shortest path, right? So what is the shortest path? Would you have 2, 6, which one is shortest? 2. So we'll consider this node as a source node or the root node right now. This part is completed now. A node is completed. Now from B we are going to find. So how many we do have? B, G. So we have selected this node. This node is still existing. Only this node we have considered. Now from B, what are the different paths we do have connected to? So we are connected to node C, node E. Okay, so they have the values. So for in the next step, what we need to do is we need to update the value of C, the value of E. This pair has to be updated, and then among C, E and G, which is the shortest path, that you have to consider. Why? Because this part is completed. Now what is left? G is already left here, so we did not consider it right now. So E we need to consider, and see among these three nodes which one is shortest, that we need to consider. So let's see in the next page. Here it is. Now, so if you observe here, E, we got the value 4 comma B. Why? Because the distance from B to E is 2. So 2 plus 2 is nothing but 4. Okay, and the same way from B to C, the value is 7. 7 plus 2 is 9, that is via B. So we updated it. So what are the three different values we have? C, E and G, right? Now, or what did I say in the next? What is the next? So this node is completed. Now we need to find the next source node. How we can determine it? Definitely based upon these three, among these three values or these three nodes what we have. That is G, E and C. Which one is having the shortest? If you observe for node C, it is 9. For node E, it is 4. And node for G is 6. So obviously E is shortest, so we are going to consider this as the next source node. And remember that these are already in the queue. G and C are already in the queue. Now from E, you are having three different paths to B, G and F. Now when we have like this, we need to find out if we have any shortest path or not. If we have a shortest path to that particular node, then we can replace it. Since G is already visited, that doesn't mean that this value cannot be changed. If you are getting less value than 6, then that can be updated. Same way, if you are getting less value than 2, that can be updated. Now from E, so three nodes we have. So which one from E to F you can directly update, because the value is infinite comma dash. I'm not able to provide that. So here you can write it something 4 plus 2 is nothing but 6. So 6 comma E for F. And coming to B, since we are coming from B, you cannot get a shortest path, because 4 plus 2 again 6. So shortest path for B is 2. So definitely we can't do that. And if you come to G here, if you observe here, 4 plus 1 is 5. But initially what the value we got is 6. Shortest distance is 6 from A. But right now we are getting a shortest distance via E. That is what 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 comma B. So that 5 from 5. Sorry. Yeah. So that is what represented in this particular table. See here. So what we did is we actually updated it, since we got the shortest distance. Okay, so now what you can see is what is the shortest route from source node A to source node G is distance is 5. The shortest distance is 5 via which particular node? It's not via directly, it's via node E. Okay, you're getting it. So we have updated here. So you can observe 6 comma E, and now this node is completed. Now now we need to find out which node acts as a source node. So in the here, I already told you that once this is completed, already this is in the queue, because we have updated right now. This one also we have updated right now, and this one we already did not visit yet. So among 9, so if you observe here, among 9, 6 and 5, which one is shortest? So 5. So we will consider this as a source node. So these two will be in the queue. C and F will be in the queue. Now from G, how many paths we do have? So okay, G to A, G to E, G to H, right? But okay, so among these three, we cannot go to C, because source node, if you observe here, the shortest distance is 0, right? So since the source node is this, so definitely we're not going to consider that. Now G to E, can we consider? No. Why? Because we are coming directly from E. So you can see here, so we are not going to consider this particular path. So only path that is left is G to H. So we need to update this particular value. How we can do it? So what is the value? 5 plus 4 is 9. So here you will be getting 9 comma G. So that is the value you got, 9 comma G. You got it right. Good. Now here, what are the values we do already existing here? So all these part is completed. Now we are left with C, F and H, which one is having the shortest path? These are already in the queue. I told you before itself. So among six, this is 9. If you observe here, this is 9, this is 6, and this is nine, right? So which one is shortest? If you observe here, this is the shortest. So now we'll make F as a source node. So this is what we actually made it here in this particular step. F. Now for F, we have two different routes, one to H, one to C. So we can update it again. So if you observe here, what is the distance from F to C is 3. So what is the value we got here? 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. So here also we are getting 9 via B. So obviously, since both the distances are equal now, you can take the initial distance itself. Okay, so you don't have to consider this. So we'll leave this as it is. This value will leave as it is. Next comes H. So 6 plus 2 is how much? 6 plus 2, it's 8. But previously, the shortest distance what we received is 9 via G. Now you are getting now another shortest distance, much more shorter distance than that. That is 8, right? So that you're going to update here. So what you're going to write here is 8 comma F, right? So this is what we did here, 8 comma F finally. So we got it. Now we are left only with the 2 in the queue, that is C. F is also completed. Now C is there, H is there. Among 2, 9, 8, which one is shortest? H is shortest. So we are considering this as the root node. Finally, we are going to reach to the, so there is only a single path from H to D. So we'll add that value, since it is infinite comma this, we'll update it. 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 comma H. Okay, so once we did this, which one is the source node? We have 9 and 10. Okay, so if you that way, okay, first I'll show you the updated one. This is updated one, what we have, 10 comma H. Now we are left only with two paths, that is C and D. Among this, which is having the shortest path, 9, you will make this as a root node. So 9 plus 3, how much we are getting? 12. But the shortest path to D, what we received is 10 via H. So we are not going to update anything in this. We'll keep as it is. And this is the final value what you people have received, a final graph. Now with this is the ultimate graph what we got. And with the help of this, you can say, if I ask you, what is the shortest path from a source node A to F? You can say it is via, the shortest distance is 6. And it is via E. Okay, so what is the path you have here? E. So where is E here? So via 4B. So what is the path? If I ask you what is the path from A to F, you have to write A, B, E, F. How you are going to get it is, go from destination to source from F. What is the intermediate node we got? E. So F, then E. You got it from B and then A. So A, B, E, F. This is the shortest bit. What is the shortest distance you have here is 6. This is a 6. Same way, if I ask you what is the shortest distance from source node A to source node D, that is, you can say directly it is 10. Okay, tell me the path where how we can go. Then you can go from destination to source. That is, you can start from D. So it is H. So from D, H. Okay, don't write it. So we have to write from source node only, but we are backtracking it. Okay, so D to H. H got it the shortest path from F. So where is F here? So F got it from E. That is here. He got it from B. So A, B, E, F, H, D. This is the shortest path from A to F. Okay. And what is the shortest distance we got here is 10. This way you people have to write it and they'll have marks. Okay. Thank you for this particular video. In the next video, I'll give you the next problem what I gave you. I'll provide information on that. Thank you.